All right, our viewers have sometimes called us with the feedback that we don't often cover projects in cities beyond the top 8. That's because we get questions predominantly from Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata, Bangalore, Chennai and Hyderabad. And as and when we get questions, we do go to cities like Jaipur, Indore, Chandigarh and Ahmedabad. And recently we've received a call for the city of Nashik. So here's a report which gives you an overview of the third largest industrial city of Maharashtra.
Around 160 kilometers away from Mumbai, situated on the banks of the Godavari River, is Nashik, the third largest city of Maharashtra. Long considered a paradise for retired people, Nashik has successfully replaced this image by a more cosmopolitan look, leveraged by improved transport facilities and better infrastructure. Nashik's central location on the India map, good connectivity, affordable labor have encouraged significant number of industries to set up shop in the city.
There's a lot of industrial activity that is happening in Nashik, primarily because it is that golden triangle, as we call it, Mumbai, Nashik and Pune. And it is getting developed because Mumbai-Nashik highway is a four-lane highway now. Nashik-Pune roads are getting under expansion moveways. So what is happening is transport corridors are developing. And because of this, a lot of industrial activities happening in Nashik.
Large companies like Crompton and Greaves, Mahindra and Mahindra and India Bulls have invested in the Nashik market. These industries have built their units in some of the upcoming areas like Sinnar, Ambad, Satpura and Andgaon. Total industrial investment over the last 1 year has been to the tune of nearly 4,000 crores. And with industrialization taking off, how can real estate be lagging behind? Over the last 1 year, Nashik has witnessed a slew of new launches in the residential housing market, specifically catering to the budget segment. However, if a report by the research firm PropEquity is anything to go by, the response to these projects has so far not been encouraging. Total unsold stock within Nashik stands at 3,700 units, out of which nearly 3,200 units were launched in last 1 year. Promoters claim that the government's taxation policies has made it difficult for them to hold back the prices, which has largely impacted demand.
At the one end, government wants us to provide affordable homes with reasonable rates, reasonable budget. And other side, tax burden has been going to increase in terms of VAT, service tax, LBT, etc.
However, it's not just the government's taxation policy that is responsible for dampening residential demand in Nashik. Availability of land has also prompted people to build independent houses rather than opting for apartments developed by private promoters. Experts say service sectors like the IT companies have refrained from entering this market mainly due to the lack of right-skilled people.
The cities like Nashik also, if you look at it, A, we have got enough piece of land available within the convenient distance, so that is where your density is low. If the density is low, the prices will continue to be low. Second is that since the population base itself is low, you don't have enough employable base for the IT sections.
With the significant number of launches in the last 1 year, the Nashik residential market probably offers the widest range of options amongst emerging cities of Maharashtra. However, with promoters reeling under the government's taxation burden and service industries not yet willing to enter the city, it will take some more time before the residential market here sees a substantial jump in demand or prices. In Mumbai, Arjun Chaudhary for NDTV Profit.
That's Nashik for you, and of course we'll keep bringing you reports, special reports from all the key cities and emerging real estate markets from across the country. If you've got a question, call us or just write into us at property@ndtv.com.